Good evening. Yes, it's another evening start to the video. It's actually 5 past midnight, but... And I'm bored. I'm not actually tired yet, I'm just bored. I'm waiting for a video to finish rendering up. Or saving, whatever you want to call it. So I can upload it to YouTube. I was just browsing good old Facebook. And someone posted a thing, a fake article that says Justin Bieber in critical condition after he crashes his brand new Lamborghini. Me being the skeptical bastard that I am, and I will freely admit I'm very skeptical, especially to things I see on Facebook. I went and googled it, and it turns out that my hunch was right, it's a hoax. Mainly because, usually if anything like that happens, you would see it plastered all over mainstream media. But yeah, it just amazes me at the amount of people that, despite Google being there, they don't use it. They would actually rather be sheep and believe this stuff, you know, than think for themselves and think, oh, I'm just going to check this just to make sure it is true or false. Because 9 times out of 10, a lot of the crap you see on Facebook is false. It's just bollocks made up because they know damn well idiots are going to fall for it and share it. It's the same with all the fake competitions. People fall for them. Because there's fake Facebook groups or pages, I should say, set up that say you could win a brand new Range Rover. Just like and share and blah blah blah. Winner will be announced on such and such date. Such and such date gets here, no winner announced. No surprise. But you'll see when you look at their Facebook page, it's just got the same damn competition. Just spread all over. It's actually one of the common ones that was doing the rounds a couple of months ago was... For the first time in Facebook history, we are giving away a brand new Range Rover. No, they're not. I don't need to go to hoaxlayer.com to figure out that it's a hoax. I just have to go and look at the page itself. Because there were several variations of this competition posted on their page. All saying winner will be announced, and some, the dates had passed when they were going to announce a winner, and no winner. But it really does strike me as amazing how many people actually do fall for it. Well, I'm actually wondering if they fall for it, or are they just, you know, do they just have the mindset that, oh well, not losing anything by sharing it, which you're not really, are you? But you're not going to gain anything either, so it's a waste of time either way. But I suppose, in a sense, it's harmless because you're not going to win anything, you're not going to lose anything, so... But, yeah. There was another one I saw posted yesterday, which was a hoax. And I can't remember what it was. It was one of my friends on Facebook actually posted it. My cousin. What the hell did she post? Oh yeah, the death of Mr. T. That was a hoax. It's what they call a like farming scam. Or a share scam, you know. What a lot of pages do. They will share things like that. Just to get the page popular, because they can sell the page. That is exactly what happens. I follow several, or at least one of the pages I follow, Asperger's Syndrome Awareness, he's been offered money for his page. Well, shit you not. He's had private messages of people offering money just because it's a popular page. That is it, all it is. So that's what a lot of people do, just to make a quick buck. And they will just share random things, even all these hoaxes and things, because they know people will share it and they will like it and whatnot. And I think he's done. Anyway, nature is calling, so I'm going to do that, and I may come back before bed. But if not, I will see you when I wake up in the morning at some point. Anyway, hopefully, I'll talk to you in a bit. Well, that's me a few pounds lighter. And yes, I did decide to put the camera back on for a bit. I did actually just wipe 20 minutes of footage because I thought I'd rattled on for far too long. Yeah, basically I think my plan for tomorrow is going to be, once that kid's bike has been picked up, I'm going to head down to Wilco and grab a set of bottom bracket bearings and at least get the bottom bracket and crank fitted. And then Thursday I'm going to go down after a full set of brake cables, I should say. Two gear, two brake. Like I said, I don't need the cable, but it's cheaper for me to go and buy a brake cable with the outer covering as well than it is to go and buy the covering separately. So I'll have a brake cable for the Claude Butler at least. Suppose I could fit it, that would be one less job to do on the Claude. Anyway, I'm going to get the Giant done first, because no, I couldn't fit a brake cable to the Claude because I don't have any brake levers. I've got some trigger shifters with the built-in brake levers. Could use those, but the reason I hadn't is because it's missing the little disc in the top. I suppose it don't really matter that much, does it? Because it's only the disc that indicates what gear you're in. And after using 8 speeds on my other Claude Butler for the past year, I pretty much know that without looking at the disc. So, I might actually do that instead. I do believe they work. Yeah, they work. It's just missing the disc cover. I'll do that then. So if I can find enough outer casings up, then I could fit the cable to that. I've got plenty of other brake cables in my blue box over there somewhere for the front cable on this Giant. My brother was online an hour ago. Apparently he's been quiet today because he's had one hell of a migraine. He gets them now and again. It's because of his eyesight. He's got, can't remember what it is now, he's got some sort of problem with his eyesight that causes migraines. He can see perfectly fine. I can't remember what the condition is called now. He's happy his laptop's working, so that's good. I've got his old case working down here with my guts in it, my Windows 7 guts in it, that is, because it's a nicer case. I think I may have thrown out the grill for the front, I'm not sure. Ah, no, it might be in the red box under the bed. if it's going to be anywhere. Right, so I'm going to turn the camera off, I think. I've got the brake blocks roughly set up in the Giant. Only because it's hard to sort of hold them against the wheel so I can see where they've got to be. And then, you know, you need like three hands. One to hold the brake block, one to hold the actual brake lever piece, and one to hold the hexagon key to undo and do up the bloody securing nut on the brake block. So what I like to do is get them roughly set up. When I put the cable on, I'll use the cable as like my third hand, if you like, and just bolt the cable clamp down just enough to hold the cable and the brakes in place, and then I can set the brake blocks up. And yeah, job will be good. Right. This has actually got a very nice pair of trigger shifters on this. I like them. I really can't wait to get that done so I can ride it. I've sort some lights out, I've got to sort some reflectors. Oh, what the flaming hell is wrong here? Certain movement and that feels like a nerve. Jesus. Yeah, I've got some lights over there, I've got some lights down, I've got lights everywhere. Should be old school with my green rally and put some of these on the wheels. Yeah. Old Kellogg's reflectors. I'm actually watching on eBay some spoke reflectors, just like the one I've got on my back wheel here. I might get a couple of new ones. They're like £1 something on eBay, but I think Roy's in town at one point was selling them. I don't know if they still are. So I'll have a look there first Thursday before I decide. But I thought as they were like less than £2, I might as well just get another one and put on the front wheel. That one's working fine. I don't know how the hell you get in there to change the battery, but you can change the battery. Anyway, I'm rattling on too much again. Oh, not as long as I thought, but yeah. I'm just going to unplug that. I don't need that plugged in. I don't like leaving adapters plugged in that I'm not using. But I will plug the camera in to charge. So, I'll turn the camera on some point in the morning when I wake up. But it's not going to be long before I go to bed. I think this video is at the processing stage now. 67%. Okay, so that's not going to be long. I'll just put a title in, put the tags in, click monetize, and then I'm going to piss off to bed. So, I'll see you in the morning. Well, I'm awake. Well, I've actually been awake since 10:30-ish. It's now 11:45. Whew, I've let myself wake up. I'm just waiting on them to come and pick that bike up. Then I'll go get something to eat. Right, That's right. I'll take those downstairs. Decided on putting those ones on the rally. On the Rally Max, that is. Really. Suppose I should have a bit of a clean up. Right on my back. Right. Completely forgotten what I was going to bloody do. Disappeared yet? So I disappeared in the tractor earlier.
People.
Reverse, and yes, it has been raining. I'm not sure if it's raining now, but it has been raining. I suppose I should sort. They said short. Short some of this out. What we got? Reflector. Go in there. Cable in the bedroom. I've got bits in here that really do not go in there. How'd you go up on my shelf? Right. Oh, packing my ass on the floor, that's the easiest option. Couple more memory sticks. Oh, we've got loads of these in here. Box for that. Reflector bracket. Ooh. Oh. Might be a bit of a bugger to get that off there because I stuck to one of them hard drive magnets. They're pretty damn strong. Another light bracket. What did I do with the other one? I'm sure I had another light bracket. Right, these have got to go in the bag to go downstairs. And that. Bracket for something, I'm not sure what that is. Then we had a light bracket, so I'll put all those beside me. Pump bracket. Wire and bins over the other bloody side, isn't it? Brake blocks. Get rid of the other brake blocks. Torch. It's no wonder I never find a bloody torch when I want one. Oh yeah, that got to go in the bedroom as well. Hey look, the other one! I can't bloody find them when I want them either. Another torch. One bits of lamp bracket. Stem. Oh. I've got a torch here that has fallen to pieces. Somehow fallen to pieces. I'm not sure how that fell to pieces, but... it's fallen to pieces. Brick block. Well, there's the LED part of it. How the hell this fell apart like this in here, I don't know. I found one of the batteries. I think there's like three batteries to go with it. I've got lots of... little bits of crap in here as well. Batteries. There's a surprise. Batteries. I need to go through this and chuck fucking rubbish out. Reflector. In the bag of bits to go downstairs. Bracket. Bracket. That one's had it, some of the bearings fell out. Ain't no good. And the brake block goes downstairs. Light bracket. Brake. A few tools and a few other bits in here. A lot of smaller bike parts, which isn't a bad thing because I've got the drays out for them. I'll chuck them in the tray later. What else we got? It's come off one of them things. May want that to put on my Rally Max. Might as well clean it up. Oh, piss off. Ring away, I'm not answering. Don't want to answer. Nope, not going to answer. There's a reason why I didn't answer at all. Oh, that one's got to go in the bin because it's bent. Should have brought my bin over this way, actually. You see, I've got all these little bike bits in here. That lot will, I'll sort out and put it up in the tray. It's got to go downstairs as well. And put the trays up there as I've got them out. Pinch bolt, it's a pinch bolt. Pick out all these bits that I've got to go elsewhere. Might as well. Ah, there's another one. Sweet, I can replace both with nice shiny ones. Now I just need another chrome seat post. The one on it is it's a little rusty round the top where it's been exposed to the elements. Not a big issue for now, but I don't think I've actually got one either. There's another one I've got to pop those in. Just some nuts and some washers in here from the look of it. I'll try to sort out and put in pots. Lighter, some rubbish. Dynamo light bracket there for a dynamo and the rear lamp. A few tools in here. Bit of speaker wire, may need that. And that. It's tempting to throw it, but I may actually need it. So, knackered. Tray for those bolts. Any more? A couple more. I know that one's one as well, so is that one. Chuck that. Another piece of wire. Old fashioned handlebar grip, spring. I've got a little tray for that as well. Clamp for a derailleur, rear one. Right. I think we've only found one battery. There's no way that thing ran on one battery. I'm sure it had at least two. The other batteries definitely aren't in there unless they've fallen out. I'm tangled up in that mess over there. Who knows? Right, I've got to stand up now. Pick that up off the carpet as well. It doesn't matter how much I try, I always end up finding those on the carpet, and I try my best not to drop them. But like I said, no matter how much I bloody try, it still happens. Right. If I remember, I'll take that. I do worry about you sometimes, Nemo. I'm surprised you didn't. If that was empty, he'd have probably got in it fully. And sat in it or slept in it. Right. Is that the bag? Yep. Just a bag of stems and other brake parts to go downstairs because that's where the boxes are.
So.
I'm going to fill that up. See, there's brake levers in here. They don't go in there. Oh! Oh! Yeah, I've got to go in my gear shifter box. Completely forgot about those. Okay. So I better get my ass into gear and get some stuff sorted. Chunky shit down there. Some of it may end up going in the bin. Right. 13 minutes. Ooh. All right then. I'll talk to you later. Right. Well, the bike has been picked up. So I've gone and got the bearings. So I thought, might as well show you how it's done. I'm going to open the packet up. Got the grease and bearings all out on the floor. That goes over there, go in the bin. Now the first thing I need to do, I've already gone ahead and cleaned everything up. So all I've got to do is install. Now with the shaft here, you want the longest side, usually, to go in first. And the bearings, if you look, you've got this side, then you've got like a flat side. Flat side goes on first. I'm just going to put the grease on, if it actually comes out the tube. Squirt all that over. Good helping of it. Just use the tube, spread it around a bit. There we go. It's all in there. Then you just simply stick it in like that and give it a little rotate just to work the grease in. Now, we take the cup. We put the bearings in with the flat side up. In fact, I'll just change that. I'm going to squeeze a bit of grease into the cup first. Like that. Drop the bearings in. Squeeze in a bit more grease around the bearings. Like so. And then that should just screw it in. Be careful not to cross thread it. I haven't got my tool for this out, but I shouldn't actually need it. There's the lock ring, I will need that. I'm nuts here, put the box that I've got the camera on top of the bloody thing, but I will need that just to clean off the excess. Right, keep going in. Oh, we're nearly there. That's it. Try and give the lock ring a bit of a clean. Do it up all the way tight yet because it may still require a bit of adjustment. But they're as simple as that to put together. And actually, with this cup, there's a rubber seal that goes around here as well. I forgot to mention that. It's actually a good idea because it keeps a lot of dirt and muck out. I'm just gonna spin that. Get some grease worked in. Right. Next job will be to bolt the crank on. Now, I've got one one part of it is in here, the other part is in the bedroom. I think that's because I took one side off in the bedroom, then decided to take the other side off in here. Right. Oh, I just opened up the wrong tub. I've got too many tubs up here. Oh, I hate dull days like this because the lighting is also crap. Right. In this magic and wonderful little tub here, I do actually have some bolts. Now, one of the original ones had lost the little plastic, I'm not sure what it is actually, seal or something. So it looked, oops, like that. And they were a little rusty, so I'm going to change them and just put these nice clean ones on. Just a second. There's one laying where it shouldn't be. There we go. So I will need those. I will need a little bit of play in that, so I'm just gonna. Hopefully, my tool is up here. There you go. Yes, it is. No, it isn't. That's the wrong one. It's because I'm looking in the wrong tray. Duh. I need that. And the ratchet. This will go on the ratchet, that is. So for this particular type of cup, you need one of these. And you've actually got a choice with these. You can put them on the end of a ratchet like that, or it's got that sort of hexagonal piece around there, so you could use a large wrench if you desired. That's just going to make turning that in a bit more. Right. I want to whack this side on while I'm here. Put the bolt in. Now, I think they're 8mm bolts. I think. 8mm hex bolts, I should have said. Now. Oh. Sort the bloody toolbox out again. Is that an 8? It is 8mm. That just goes like that. I'm not going to do it up too tight for now though, because I may have to take it off to make adjustments to the cup. Because sometimes when you do this, they might work themselves loose again. Whee. Which in this case, I don't think they have. Certain it hasn't. Right, well I'm just going to go close that. I'm going to turn the bike around. Oh dear. going to zip into the bedroom. I know exactly where the crank is. I guess the bike just moved. No, it didn't. That must have been the cat then. Right. Just make sure the bike isn't going to go anywhere. Now, of course, you need this one to go in the opposite direction to the one on the other side, otherwise it won't work. So. Oh, yeah. It's a good job I didn't. Tighten this derailleur up all the way, because it is actually in the wrong place. And the hexagon key I want has fallen into the depths of my toolbox, I think. I think they would have fell out, didn't they? Yep. Bullocks is the answer to that. I have to raise this derailleur a little bit. Raise it there. Just do it up enough to hold it in place. Get the chain around the bottom sprocket. Hopefully. And knocking everything off. I wonder if I can get this chain to actually sit like that for the time being while I get this on here. I should be able to work the chain onto the sprocket like so, in theory. And there, that's on there. Right. So, I put the derailleur too high, but that doesn't matter. I'll adjust that in a moment. The rear derailleur looks fine. I'll go ahead and bolt this one on. It needs to be cranked down much harder than I have, but like I said, I've only done it. Is that actually the bottom bracket, or is that this that's wobbling? It's the other side I'll have to adjust, so. A little bit of play in there, so I may have to pop the other side off. But drop the derailleur into position. Where's my hex key for that? See if I can't get it lined up while I'm at it. A bit lower. Not too much lower, but just a bit. Somewhere. Somewhere right there should be fine. Kind of doing it blind because I can't see the bloody bolt. Just gonna do that up lightly for now. Right. So there is a bit of play in there. I'll sort that in a second. There we go. The crank's back on, and the bloody plastic thing keep falling out of this, so I'm not going to bother with it this side. That derailleur should be sat there. That's in a better position. What's it going to be like if I had that on top?
should work.
Way you wear, you bastard. There we go. Same for you at this end.
There we go.
So that's that job done. Well, just got to adjust the other side of that. Maybe, and this is just a maybe, I can get in there. With a little flathead screwdriver and a small hammer. Which would be good, because that would actually save me having to take that crank arm off again. Might work. Is it going to push that around or? Let's see if I'll just get that to rotate a little more. Try that. Right, we're getting there. I need cables, that is it. Front dahlia is in the correct position. The bloody phone is bloody ringing again. I'll be back in a bit. Right, I'm back. That was Mum on the phone. She's changing internet provider because she looked at her bank account and found that British Telecom, or BT for short, has decided to try to take well over 70 quid out of her bank account, which has made her overdrawn. Because, well, overdrawn with bank charges, because obviously the money's not there to be taken, so. But, she's sort of thinking that's taking the piss, because she just gets your standard broadband, because she can't get fibre optic out there. Now, I was, till I took a couple of things off my package, I was paying about £60 on mine, and I have fibre optic, but I've taken a package off, and with fibre optic broadband, which is what I get, I'm now paying £45 and some odd pence a month. Well, actually, it should be less than that, because I know the £5 something was actually phone calls. So that actually proves how little I use my phone, as I only spent £5 worth, or spent £5 on calls for the past month. And they're trying to charge Mum 70 odd quid for normal broadband, and she doesn't use the phone that much. Something wrong there, so she's moving, changing provider. So she just wanted a bit of advice. Anyway, crank is on, chain is on, derailleur readjusted because it was on the piss. That'll teach me to try and line the derailleur up at a funny angle, wouldn't it? That's all lined up now. All I need to do is go to Wilko's tomorrow and get the parts I need. Where's it gone? One of these, because I'm going to reuse this one. I don't know, front or rear, I haven't decided yet. It's not perfect, but I just think I'll skim over with some steel wool and that'll be fine. Four cables, just because I need the outer. And a pair of handlebar grips. Oh, and the little metal cable ends. To stop the ends fraying, because I've only got one left in my toolbox. And I'm going to need at least a couple on my Green Rally Max, because I've put the classic style lights on the bike. I'm going to put these bridges on. The ones on there have gone rusty, so I figured, well, I've got these clean ones here, might as well clean the bike up and make it look as pretty as possible as well. So I have a nice, you know, nice, pretty, new-ish bike. So I actually don't know how old this one is. Probably not that old, to be honest. I don't know, though. I don't know how you can tell an age of a bike. I'll have a pretty-looking classic mountain bike as well. And when I'm done, I need to find reflector brackets. I'm going to change those as well. Just the brackets, reflectors are fine. I just want to put some nicer brackets on. And I bought a pair of brand new ones, 50p each, out of a charity shop. Now I can't find them. Front one was in the tub that was up here, but I pulled that out. I actually thought I threw it in the reflector box, but I can't see it in there. Oh, it's because I didn't, because it's here. But yeah, I've got a pair of these, nice brand new black brackets as well. I've got a rear one, which I am pretty certain is in there. So I'm not going to use the reflectors because I don't need them, I just want the brackets. And then that'll be done. It shouldn't take me too long just to do the brakes on that. I could do that tomorrow as well. I know I'll see Mum after work, so I'll get distracted then, but I'm going to spend most of the day. I'll go and take a trip around the charity shops and my favourite junk shop and see what goodies I can find. Probably not a lot, because there never really is a great deal in this town for some reason. I don't know. It could just be me. I better try and find some jeans as well while I'm in the charity shops. Anyway, well, actually, I've got nothing to do. I could go downstairs and do all that now and just put the cable ends on tomorrow when I get them. Possible. I don't know. I need to find a pair of reflectors for that. I am changing the lights that I'm going to put on that. I'm going to put on... I bought a bag of bits up, I bought all the lights up that I took off the rally and whatnot. But I decided I'm going to put these lights on that one. So, that's what I'm going to do. Got enough room on there to put a light and a reflector on the seat post, so that's what I'm going to do. But I'm going to do that last, because they'll just get in the way when I put the cables and everything on. So I could do them now, but it just means I'd have to work around the lights and reflectors. Which I'd have to do if I was repairing anyway, but as they're not there, do it the easy way. Yeah, rusty screw. Oh well, one rusty screw won't hurt. Right, I'm going to turn the camera off. I might disappear downstairs just to do that if I can find that other blasted rear reflector. Okay, been a busy bumblebee. Got the chain on this and I've realised I've put... Well, this has got the exact same rear derailleur as the Giant. Got the chain on, front derailleur on, set up. I think... may need to just lower that smidge. and a front brake. But I didn't realise I've got no bolts in these. I'm going to have to find a couple of bolts. I know what I can pinch them out of if I can find them. And also, yeah, put the giant in here for the time being, but I've got front brake on this one as well. I found a good piece of outer up, so I just figured, why not, you know? Now, in theory, I think I can get away with perhaps buying just the one brake cable. I think I've got the two bits cut to go there. I need one down there, so it would just be three pieces I'd need to cut. And as for, let's turn the light off. Hate dull days like this. If you notice, I've got blue on the front of this one, because I completely forgot until I found the blue outers up that I was going to put blue on the brake cables on this one, and black on the gear cables. So I've got this length of blue here to cut off to go on that part down to the brake. I've also found, when I find it, another good clean brake noodle. It's not that one. Here it is. See? So that saved me some cash. I've only got to buy one. There is no more clean ones in here though, I don't think. Whoopsie. That's my balance. Sort of half clean ones, but for the sake of £3 or £4, I'll just buy a new one. But I do believe maybe if I have a dig around a bit more, I might find some more cable outers I can use. Because I'm almost out, that's why I was going to buy the two brake cables, but I found that odd one for the giant. I'll have a poke around, I might find another one laying somewhere. I've got to change the saddle. I'm going to take the post out of there, that'll be easier. The other thing I'm going to do, so this is going to be a bit of a long video. I'm going to do a bit of dumpster diving late tonight. So if I don't include that on this video, I'll do what I've done before and I'll start the next day's video or tomorrow's video late tonight when I get back from dumpster diving. It's a charity bin and I saw someone wheel on a trolley thing a trash can full of some electrical bits. Now the thing with charities is most of them, at least in my town, will not sell electrical goods because they have to get them tested by law, which of course, unless one of their volunteers is trained in pat testing and can do it for free, they get charged. So they don't all the way, not many of them like to sell electrical goods. So if they get any electrical goods donated, 9 times out of 10, they're going to go straight in the bin. As I saw today, I should have asked really, but I was actually waiting for that bike to be picked up, so. But that doesn't matter, I'll go and fish it out later. I don't know what they were, they looked like projectors or something. And perhaps like a sandwich toaster. Who cares if they work or not, it's something I can take apart and video it. Or something I can, if it works, and I can keep it and perhaps put it in my museum in the bedroom. I came back through this way for something, but I can't remember what it was for. Oh, I know what I'm going to do. So, actually, I'll do that when I've got the camera off, but I need to get under there and just sort the bloody plug out for that light in the cupboard. Brush, cables, I've got a pile of cables on the bed to go through. Bike lights to stick back under the bed. I've decided for a rear light on this, because I think I will end up keeping it. I'm going to use one of these. Maybe not this one, because one has got a crack in the top there. And two, I don't know if I like it. I've got some more somewhere. Well, I think they're about £3 in Roy's, brand new, so I could just buy a brand new one. But I'll put one of them on the rear. Tape stuck to my boot. And there's a Sturmey Archer one with a built-in switch that I'll bolt to the front and just wire it up to a 6-volt battery. I could do with putting the battery in a little box or something. One, that'll make it look tidy, and two, that'll keep the damp off of it, so at least the contacts won't rust. I'll have to find something up or make something. It's got to be big enough to house a 6-volt rechargeable battery. I could do some spade crimps, so I can just plug the wires straight on, so I can actually take the battery off, charge it, put the battery back on. But I don't want to put it on like just like that, because one, it's going to look stupid, and two, like I said, them contacts are going to be exposed to all the elements and they'll rust. So I'm going to have to conjure up something. And what I'm going to do, I want to sit it on here. So I need to make a box and fix it somewhere there. Perhaps with a door in the end that I can open up. So I could perhaps open up a door, slide the battery out, charge it, slide it back in, kind of thing. But those metal bars right there are actually pretty handy, because I'm not going to put any baggage on them. That's what the main part is for. I think I'll put my panniers on this one as well. I think that's what I'll do this one for, so I can scoot to the shops on it a bit, and that'll be a bit easier when I'm getting stuff and whatnot. So I need to get that epoxy charger. I may actually sacrifice 16 quid tonight and actually buy one. So I can actually just plug the battery straight in, and then I'll find a home for this somewhere in the shed. So I can stay downstairs, and I'll just bring the battery pack up to charge. But as for wiring for the lights, I could probably run it mostly to the headlight along the underside. Where am I going to... Oh yeah, I was going to say, where am I going to put a switch for the lights? And duh, the fucking switch is in the light. It's in here. Not this one, although I could use that one. That's not the one. Good old Sturmey Archer. Good old dynamos. Here it is. That's the one I want to use, and I'm going to rewire it and try and find a decent nut and bolt to replace it there, because I lost it. Because that's the sort of pillock I am, so I think that's something I'll do later. Is the wires I'll rewire, so I'm not going to join straight onto these, because that's going to look untidy. I'll put new wires straight into the lamp, and I'll solder them on if I have to. First, let's see if I find a nut and bolt. Right, so that's the plan for the rest of the evening. So you probably won't hear from me again. Actually, I may leave it and just wait until I get back, because I'll go out and get my cash out of the hole in the wall while I'm at it. Try and make payment for those epoxy games, and I need to leave something in there for Netflix or whatever. Hopefully I can get to, I need to set a car boot sale, the recycle centre this weekend. Might even do it tomorrow if I can get over to Mum's, I don't know. I may just say sod it, because there's a lot of things I want to do. I want to get both bikes done. They both just need cables now. Well, that needs new pedals, which I could do later. Let's see why I want to put new pedals on this one. They're worn on the Giant, but they're not broken like that. So, yeah, I'll try and get them off. Anyway, I'll talk to you all in about 7 hours' time, I expect, unless I think of something in between now and then. Bye. to me, the screen gets a hell of a lot brighter when I plug in the external power, you know? I suppose it goes into like an energy save when you run from the battery. Anyway, just put the camera on for a couple of minutes because, well, I went for a little bike ride to see if I could find where the fire engine disappeared to. Exercise does me good, so... and I was going to go downstairs and just paint the stem up on the Rally Max and change those cable bridges and fit the new reflector brackets, but it's pissing it down outside, so that's kind of throw a spanner in the works for that. I can't really paint in the rain, and it's a bit cold and wet. On the plus side, when I go dumpster diving later, there won't be anyone around to disturb me. It's not that I care about, you know, someone seeing me. It's just that I don't want the confrontation. I don't want to have to stand there and explain what I'm doing to some complete stranger. If that makes sense. So, yeah. The bin's locked, but I've got a key that unlocks them. The key for the electric cupboard downstairs opens wheelie bins. Or dumpsters for Americans. So, yeah. So I'll just go up to it and I'll just pop it. I think they're in the bottom. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a steel coat hanger with me. So I'll just drop it in there and use it as a fishing hook, if you like, and just hook everything up. Because sometimes I've been known to sort of like literally dumpster dive and almost end up falling in them. on my travels, I found... Where is he? Him. Laying on the side of the road. So I've got a free one. Ooh. Someone's probably dropped it. Some poor kitty has probably dropped it, but... I could put something up on Facebook, you know, saying, found, but is it really worth it? Over 29 pence? For 29 pence, you can go and buy another one. It's pocket money. Literally, kids' pocket money to buy these. You know, it's only silicone rubber stuff. Probably costs next to fuck all to make. I should put a PG-13 on my video, shouldn't I? Because I do swear occasionally. I try not to, but I do swear occasionally. That risk is going to be there. Oh well. I've got a couple of bolts for those trigger shifters on that bike. So, I'll get those sort of guesstimated and bolted down. I was actually tempted to see what other cables I could salvage. Fuck. That's what I forgot to do. I was going to look in my box of outers downstairs to see if I had any longish, decent-ish ones in black. If I'm trying to save some as much cash as possible. If I could find a gear cable that would fit at least the front gears in my box on both bikes. That's another £4 saved there. So I would literally just need to spend £6 on £7 on cables. Because I would still need two rear. And two gear. Because I don't really use the front gears that much anyway, so I could get away with doing that. I'll have a fiddle around tonight anyway and see what I can find. I might go down to the shed later and no, I won't, because I've got to move three bikes to get to the box and I ain't doing that in this weather. Sod that. I don't mind getting wet, but, you know, I don't mind getting wet if I have to get wet, you know. If I was being paid to do a job in the rain, I'd do a job in the rain, it wouldn't bother me, but still, I wouldn't do it just for the hell of it. You've got food in your day. Oh yes, another job I can do is just swap that seat post. Seat, not seat post. Not sure if that's a smoke alarm I can hear or a Sanders bus ticking over. Yeah, Sanders buses do sound weird. Anyway, I'm going to shut the camera down and, seriously, this time, for sure, the last, this time, for certain, the next time you'll hear from me is once I've been dumpster diving, and hopefully it's a success. I better get my coat hanger out. Quick update, guys. Had a bit of a boo-boo with my sharp cutters. Don't know, I guess I don't know my own strength. I was just cutting a bit of this, that is it. Something I've done hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times. In fact, I believe that's the original sharp pair that I bought 4 or 5 years ago. So I've cut no end of these and no end of brake cables and whatnot, and yeah. Oopsie. Oh well. They're blunt. Well, they're good enough for electric wires and whatnot, but... And the outer casings, they've been cutting those fine, but not cables. I've got a sharp pair downstairs. Anyway, sort of throwing a spanner in the works on this. Well, two things did. Excuse me. I've got a cable long enough for the front gears. Rear gears, as far as I know, are set up and working. Found a cable for that one. So far this has working front brake, working rear gears. If I hadn't ran out of outer casing and broke my wire cutters, I would have had working front gears as well. But two things kind of threw us. I'm not having a good night tonight, am I? Couldn't do what I wanted to do outside because it was raining. And I got so far with playing around with these bikes till my cutters went ping. I don't have... Well, I've got plenty of outer if I wanted to use white, for example. There's just... nothing in black long enough. I am out. Fresh out. So... I think I really am... going to have to go down the dump and have a look for some parts donors. And I'm having a bit of a clean out with boxes and things that I've got kicking around. That's going in the bin. I could scrap it, but is there any point really? Oh, pardon me. I know Biggles doesn't really do scrap anymore, and too late. It's gone in the bin. But I did salvage the bulb, because the bulb looks good. This lamp didn't work, but the bulb looked good. And I've salvaged this box, because I thought, well, get a good seal. You know, there's a rubber seal in there when you screw this onto there. And it sits outside in all weathers, keeping rain off things. So, you know, you could use that as a cable entry hole, as well as that. I've got a nice... outside connection box. So yeah, this thing charges up really quick with the external power supply, although the battery doesn't seem to last as long. I don't know why, but never mind. Right, so hopefully this time tomorrow I will have two working bikes. Look at this damage here. Look, just from rubbing outer cases, that's just these that I've rubbed on there, that's all that is. Oh, actually, that's quite deep, I don't think that is. That has been dropped. Yeah, that's been dropped on something, feel it, from the feel of that. That's not paint wear, that's actually in the frame. Oh well. Yeah, there's some matching marks here. I bet someone dropped this at some point. I see ya. Can't escape me and my camera. I see everything you bloody do. No, I don't really, because I'm not a nosy bastard. Right. Yep, I just thought I'd turn the camera on and just update you on progress. I do have another sharp pair downstairs somewhere. Or they were. If not, I'm going to have to go somewhere tomorrow and buy a pair because I need them. I said they won't cut. Well, I cut electric wire, but that's about it. I've got another pair which is pretty much the same. So, yeah, I'll have a look tomorrow, see what I can find. Anyway, I'll tune in later. I lied again, I said I'd wait until I went dumpster diving, but I didn't. Oh well. I don't think I'm going to change the seat, because that's going to raise me too high, that one. If you look at that bit, the metal bar, not that. And you look at that one. Oh, I don't know. I don't know, actually. And these would raise me a little bit. I think I'll just leave that seat on there for now, anyway. Right. Talk to you later tonight. Hopefully. Thought I'd give you a little update as I'm bored. I've got a cable on for the front gears. But I haven't got a clamp in the derailleur. I completely forgot there weren't no cable clamp on that. But there's one on this derailleur that I'm going to pinch off of it. I've got some cables here. I want to see if they're going to be long enough for the joint. For the front gears, that is. Sort out a few boxes. I've managed to empty that box. So that's another one for the bin. Another one out of my friggin' way. I've got these plastic tubs everywhere, so I'm sort of thinking, why don't I put those tools in one of these plastic tubs, like the blue one. Put the lid on the blue one, and that can sit in the bottom there. And things can stack up on top of it easily. Duh. That'd make a lot more sense, wouldn't it? And what I want to try and do is get a front gear cable attached to this. Well, maybe not tonight, but see if I can find one long enough. I know the one I just put on the Claude is long enough. See what I've got in there. No, I can't see anything. I've had quite a chuck out of crap as well that was in this box. I'm pretty certain these cables ain't going to be long enough. I've actually got a grip shift kicking around somewhere with a cable on it. I found it earlier and it was in something. The only problem is I can't remember what it was in. Anyway, I've got, we'll say about an hour. I'll give it till sort of 1 a.m. before I disappear out. It's actually quite quiet out there now. Ouch. But my cash doesn't go into my bank account until after midnight, so if I'm going to go dumpster diving, there's no point, excuse me, until I've done that. Well, until my cash has gone in, that's what I was trying to say. I did manage to find one last piece of long black outer. I actually nicked it. There's a brake cable in it, and the brake cable was in the bottom of that tub. Well, that's a bigger tub, and I had quite a lot of spare brake cables, so I figured I might as well stick it in the bigger tub. I'm using that blue one as my wire box, my small wire box. And I've got bits of speaker wire and I don't know what else in there. So, but yeah, somewhere in here, maybe it's in one of these bags. Is it in one of these bags? It's not in that one. Or is it? Is it actually downstairs and not up here? Nope, not that one either. Actually, it might be downstairs and not up here. No, it is up here because it was in one of these blue tubs. And I took it out. And I've put it somewhere. And I can't remember where. Oh yes, I found the other reflector I was looking for as well. Ah, there's another bit. So I use this lot of wire for, usually for the dynamo lights, but anything else I'm playing with, so I do like to keep that box full. Yeah, I found the red rear reflector in that box I sorted out in the bedroom. Ah, I found it. That'll have a long enough cable on it. The only question is, I've got to figure out how to get the cable off. I can't remember how you do it with these ones. If that's going to be long enough, then I'm going to install this roughly. Well, I'm not going to connect it, but I'll get it put into the shifter and through the outers tonight, and then I'll do all the connecting up tomorrow. If it's nice, I'll take them downstairs to do. Ah, that's it. I've got a little flathead somewhere. Any little flathead will do. Got a little plastic cap in there. I've got to pop that out. Without stabbing myself in the finger. There we go, that pops out. That comes round to the hole, and in theory, somehow, I'm going to cheat. Ow, it's meant to go through the hole, but I'll just pop it. And something just flew down there. I think I've killed the grip shift now. Yeah, because I don't want to go back together. Oh well, bin. I'm just going to trim the frayed end off of this, if my cutters will work. Bloody hell, they did work. Yay! Need that. May need that. Right, well, I just got a bit bored and just wanted to update you, and I found a couple of things, been cleaning a few things up, and still got a lot to do. Still got that box to do. I may go into the bedroom and sit and do that. Yeah, I'll see you in a bit, hopefully, when I come back from getting my bits. Right. I've been dumpster diving and I grabbed this bag. Not got a fucking clue what's in it. The only other things I could see in there was a couple of those electric George Foreman type grills. A lamp, a computer monitor, which I've got fuckloads of anyway. And an old projector, which I didn't really want the projector. I've had them before, there's not a lot in them. So, I've shut the PC down for the night, simply because I'm going to go to bed after this and I'll put the video up while I'm out in town. Right, I think these cables I grabbed go with the actual projector, but I couldn't get it even if I wanted it, because it would have made too much noise. And there's another. Yeah, that looks like a power cord for it. I'm just going to turn a bit of light on. Yeah, I grabbed this. I've got a friggin' idea of what it is. Oh, I see. I don't know what it is now. Hmm. that sorted. Here we go. Something for the ladies. So, I am guessing this is to curl your hair. It would heat all these up, and then you would just take whichever one you want. So I've simply got an on-off switch there. Yeah, might be interesting to take this apart. I've all got a red spot in the middle. They all seem to be different sizes. I expect you need the tong thing to go with it, don't you? It's got a good length of cable on it. Oh well, that was a bit of a bust, but I suppose I've still got the light and the switch I can take off of it. And, there's like a fair bit of weight in it. Ah yeah, they're curlers, Karman curlers. Yeah, must be American, US patent. And patent in all major countries. Oh, Kalundborg, Denmark. Oh, it could be Danish then. Volts AC only, 220. 840 watts. So I come up to 2 o'clock and I want to be up early. Well, I'll still be up early. Right. It's bedtime. I think I've successfully managed to get my parts bill for these bikes down to about £10. Only because I managed to find quite a few cables up. I'm going to head to the bedroom anyway, so I'm going to head that way. Beep beep, Nemo. Nemo rather, not Memo. I do use that one. I don't use the other one in the lounge though, but I haven't actually done much playing on the PS3, otherwise I would. Yeah, I've got front gear cable mounted to this as well. It was a pig to get this cover off because one of the screw heads had sort of started to ring off from just being rusty, so I'm going to replace it. I did get it off using a flathead screwdriver and a Phillips head screw, but it did work. Yeah, all I've got to do is connect the cable up and we should have front gears. So the next job... I need to get 2 packs of those cable ends because I'm going to need 3 more for this one, 4 for the other bike, and a bunch for the rally because the rally doesn't have any either. And we get 10 in a pack. Yeah, 2 packs should do it then. For 1 pack should actually do both bikes, but like I said, I'm going to need them for other projects, and I need them for my rally because I want to get some work done on that tomorrow as well, weather permitting, of course. Crank my fan on. It doesn't matter what time of year it is, I've got to sleep with a fan going. I think it's just the feeling of the breeze and the white noise of the fan that sends me to sleep. Just get that crap off there for now. Yeah. Actually, so I don't lose these, I'm going to put them back in the box. Actually, you know what, I'm keeping them. I don't think they're going to be long enough for anything. Not unless I get a child's bike in or something that needs a gear cable. So it's not bad. This one needs 1 cable. The other one needs 2. I can only get one set of grips that I want. I don't matter, I can go in another day and get another pair, or just get a different pair for this one. I have got an alternative pair there, but yeah, I don't like them. I might have a look and see what Roars have got. Never know, Roars might have something. But like I said, if not, I'll just get them another day. Because Wilco does seem... Turn the telly on as well. They do seem to, We've got adverts on. And they do seem to sell parts quite well. But I'm going to get two full brake cables. Because both the bikes need a rear cable anyway. It's only this one that needs an outer though, but... I need an outer for the rear brake cable on this one as well, so... Hold on. Where's my volume? There we go. That go over there somewhere. There's a cable for the drawers. As is that one. The cat's trying to chase friggin' cables and them nuts. Right. Computer fans to go up in my box of fans. Up there. That's all the outer I've got left, and I've got a thingy stuck on the end of it. I don't know if that'll come off. It might. With a bit of brute force. There we go. Could use that on the rear gears, actually. Like I said, I'm going to get two brake cables regardless, because I do need some extra outer. American Dad. Don't know why, but I really do like watching those shows. American Dad and Family Guy and the Cleveland Show. I don't know. Well, not everyone's cup of tea, but not every... You know, you're not going to like everything, are you? Some people will like it, some people won't. That's perfectly fine. And how the fuck did that laptop get there? Now, it's funny how I said that and the cat has just slunk off into the lounge. Guilty, maybe? Wonder what the hell that clunk was I heard through here. And I've only just noticed it. I actually forgot how nice that laptop looked. Yeah. The only logical thing I can think of is that Nemo was... walking along there. It probably hasn't done my consoles a lot of good, and it probably hasn't done the laptop a lot of good. But how else would that have fallen down if not for the cat? Or at least I think it was today it had fallen down, I don't know. That's what I like about hairballs, you just let them dry and you can just... I can hoover the fluff up, or use my carpet sweepers, floor sweepers, whatever you want to call them, the G-Tech. I think jobs for tomorrow evening will be to empty that box into one of these tubs. I might do that cardboard box as well. Mostly because it'll get these tubs out of my way, and those tubs will take the weight a lot better than cardboard boxes. And they will stack a lot better as well. That's the reason I'm converting to the tubs. And I've just realised that guy has never ever got back to me about those cars under there. So I don't know what I'm going to do with them. I'll sort that out later. I'm not doing it tonight. My neighbour won't appreciate me banging around in here, putting things back. As all these flats, the floor plan is identical, so his bedroom is right down there. You'd walk straight into his flat and it would be like walking into this one. Floor plan. Obviously he won't have all the computers and the Lego everywhere, but you know what I mean. The actual floor layout is exactly the same. And the flat's on the opposite side. So my neighbour's flat would be the mirror image of this flat. What a mess that cat makes. You're a messy little bugger. But you're my messy little bugger, aren't you? Turn that one off. I've got a rubbish bag down there to go down in the morning. What if the stores are selling new fans yet? Because it's sort of seasonal in my time. Want a floor fan again. But I haven't had one since last year when mine decided to give up the ghost altogether. This one's sort of doing the same thing. Right, well I'm going to bugger off to bed, I think. Watch a little bit of Family Guy and go to bed. So, until tomorrow. But this video is going to be extremely late because I waited for that, which was pretty much a bust, but never mind. I'll start a video again, or like I said, I'll get this one up in the morning. And then the other, or the video I make tomorrow will be going up as scheduled, around about midnight. Anywhere between midnight and 1 o'clock in the morning, my time. Anyway, see you all later.